The traffic on I-40 is horrible, but part of the reason's because there's a darn good football game going on here today. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Virginia Tech is lined up to kick the ball off first, and we are ready to go. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 27-yard line. There's a flag down, and it looks like this one's coming back. Clipping is the call, and now they'll have to find a way to make up those yards right here. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. He's got his man across the middle. Close to 9-yard pickup there on the slant. Tackle at about the 19-yard line.
That's got to be very frustrating for that running back. This offense is trying to get in sync and trying to get a rhythm established, and for such a negative play to happen, loss of yards, that can really have a negative impact on the offense and what they're trying to do.
Third down, 5 yards to go. Ball on the 19. Fires it out. He's taken down at the 33.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
Over the middle to his tailback. They'll bring him down around the 43-yard line. And he's tackled at the 49-yard line. Roberson picks up 6 yards with that grab.
Heads up play by the quarterback to find his receiver in traffic and get the ball into his hands.
And he's tackled after positive yardage. Brought down at the 41-yard line. He's taken down at the 45-yard line. Robinson awaiting the return. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. Fires that quickly, incomplete.
This is a well-designed play by the offensive coordinator. Everything really seemed to be working just fine, except for the quarterback. He's got to throw a better football.
From their own 20-yard line, it's second down. Herbert off the left side. And he's level at the 20. Airing it out long. Through his hands.
Let's see if the momentum from that defensive stand carries over to their offense.
They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick. Made at the 44-yard line. They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. come out in a 5-wide set. Receivers got the first down, and they make the stop at about the 39-yard line. They must have seen something in the defense because that was the exact same play as the one they ran before.
Exactly the same play. The defense better make some adjustments because right now there's a mismatch that the offense has taken advantage of.
Quick throw, and he's got his man again. And down he goes at the 5.
Huge play for both the quarterback and receiver, but it all starts with the big fellas up front who provided the time to get the quarterback a chance to throw.
Quick pass, intercepted. Good job to pick that ball off.
He did a great job at getting in that passing lane and coming away with the ball.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 37. Zips it to the tight end. He's tackled at about the 49.
Tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
Got it. And he goes down quickly.
The defense was ready for that pass and catch, and they did a good job to hold them for such a short game.
Trying to change the field position with his kick. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback.
Boy, this has really been stingy by both of these defenses. The question is, can they keep this pace up, though?
I think that's a big challenge for them to be able to continue to play like this. Right now, the emotion of the game is favoring the two defenses, but I get a feeling it's a matter of time until one of these offenses starts clicking.
He might have a chance. Nice run there as they work the outside. Lets it fly. He almost had it, but it's incomplete.
Brady drops the ball here. I don't know if he's starting to peek downfield and think about the return or what, but that ball's right in his hands. He just dropped it.
Third and 6. Ball on the 24-yard line. And he tackles him hard at the 35. Five wide. Gains his way to the 43-yard line. Little handoff. Nice run to the outside. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. Hit out of bounds at about the 45. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. Tackle made around the 39-yard line. Complete
complete for 6 yards, and that's good for a first down.
Short throws like this are very effective because they tend to wear down the defense over the course of a game, especially when they get you a first down and keep the offense on the field.
Tackled after a decent pickup.
Concentration lapse right there. The coaches will be giving them an earful for it, too.
From the 19-yard line, first down. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. They bring them down in the backfield. Tenth play of the drive.
Let's go, defense. Let's go, defense. All right, here we go. 15's the mic. 15's the
mic. Nice run, and he's brought down. Gain of 6 on the draw play. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. Converts the extra point. An 11-play, 75-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Fred, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drop. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So our score, 7-0. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. King takes it at the 4. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. Wake Forest's defense really came to play early in this football game.
Well, they've done a good job here early, but you know eventually this offense is going to start clicking. Let's see if this defense can sustain this for the rest of the game.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Makes the catch, and look out. Tackled at about the 37-yard line. Hits him hard at the 40-yard line. They come out in an empty backfield. And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
Hesitant on that throw, and that left the defender time to break on the ball and pick it off.
From the 47-yard line, it's first down. Wake Forest is up 7.
Ready, 12, 50.
He gets out to about the 45-yard line. After 1 quarter of play, and we've got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. Demon Deacons on this with a touchdown lead. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the 2nd quarter. And he throws it away. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 37. Catches it and hits. for a loss. They lose four there.
Well, that play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
He's going to try to coffin corner this one. They'll bring him down at the 20-yard line.
Brett, everywhere we go when we travel over the country, people want to talk about offense. Oh, the spread or the pistol. Hurry up, tempo offense and points. It's nice to watch a team that prides itself on playing great defense. And when it's all said and done, the teams that advance and get to the important bowl games and do well in the postseason are teams that have this kind of defense.
Caught out in the open. He's taken down around the 28-yard line. Gains his way to the 36-yard line.
Yes, sir. You don't want that. You don't want that. You don't want that.
Here comes the pressure, and he's sacked.
Perfect time to call the blitz. He took a bit of a chance, but it paid off by the linebacker being able to get through there, shoot the gap, and get to the quarterback.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. Throws complete and he's hit right away. It up the middle for a nice run. He makes it to the 32-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Wake Forest, up 7 points. And they'll get him in the backfield.
But you can really mess with an offense's game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
Second and 12 coming up here. Ball on the 31-yard line. Setting up blockers, the running back's got it on the screen. They'll bring him down at about the 35. Up the middle for a nice game. Mora to punt. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
Scrambling around. And he's tackled around the 48-yard line. Chance. There's a very impressive open field tackle.
Good track, good play.
He's on the run. Excellent open field tackle. Complete and taken down immediately. Quick throw out to the receiver. Brought down at the 8-yard line. A touchdown away from a tie. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. He steps out around the 5-yard line. They come out in a five wide set. Quick throw incomplete. One of his receivers.
This quarterback has got to do a better job of looking off defenders and allow his covered receivers some room to improvise and get free.
So it's third down, but the offense is only 4 yards away from evening this game up. They try to get a head start there. They'll line up for another third down play because of the penalty.
Well, here you're in a third down situation, and then someone makes a mental mistake. It makes your blood boil if you're a coach.
Can't get it over the line. They'll line it up for the field goal. The kick is up, and it splits the uprights. They line up to kick this one away. From his own goal line. He's tackled at the 26. Wake Forest team, when you look at them, I think they got to be happy with how versatile they can be, because they do have a star that is not having a star-type game right now, and yet they got the lead here, and we're almost at halftime.
Yeah, I think they've really shown their versatility as an offense. To think that we would be sitting here close to this first half being over, and to see that their go-to wide receivers not putting up these big numbers, and yet they still have the lead, just tells you a lot about their coaching, the in-game adjustments, and the way the rest of the teammates, this receiver, stepped up.
Five wide. Head protection, now scrambles. He's wrapped up for the sack. We've got third and 12. Ball on their own 24. Wake Forest holds a 4-point lead. Caught. Big hit. He's going to lose yardage. And that was a nice stretch for the D there.
Yeah, they really cranked it up a notch on that series.
Robinson is the deep man awaiting the return. And he's tackled at the 45-yard line. Both defenses really played well so far, Herbie.
Well, up to this point, both defenses have dominated this football game. We'll see if they can hold on to that mentality the rest of the way.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He scrambled. And he's taken down around the 45-yard line. Tries to buy some time, and down he goes at about the 47-yard line. Looks like someone got a head start on the line. It'll be third down again after that penalty.
Yeah, now they have more yards to pick up for the first down.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 45. Strike to his receiver, no good. Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt. He's pushed out of bounds at the 24-yard line. This one might be coming back, folks. Let's check out the penalty. He did a good job there to give his team decent field position. From their own 24-yard line. First down. They'll spread the field with five wide. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Wake Forest is up by four. The stop at the 27-yard line. Quick throw from their own 27-yard line. Third down. Nice run up the middle.
You admire their faith in the running game, but a pass might have been the better way to go.
The Hokies are going to have to call their third and final timeout. Mora is waiting for the snap. He makes it out to about the 37-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Throws it deep. The defender had it and then dropped it. A great first half comes to a close. Wake Forest's up by four.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game.
Let's not get too carried away by the numbers, but both of these teams averaging less than 6 yards per pass. It's an indication, it seems, that maybe there's not the personnel out there that really scares this defense, that can really stretch the defense.
Yeah, we talk about it all the time, having those big-time speed guys and those playmakers on the outsides that really make the cornerbacks bail and take away the deep ball. And they're not scared right now. They're just squatting on the outside and saying, you're not going to run by me, you're not going to throw it deep, and all I'm going to do is try to make sure that you catch the underneath stuff and wrap you up and tackle you. So somebody has to emerge as a playmaker, and you have to find the playmakers down the field to make some big home run plays.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes 3 or 4 axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
Great first half. Hopefully the second half's as good. He's to the 20. He makes it to the 28-yard line. Demon Deacons on this continues to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. He's tackled right around the 26-yard line.
Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
from their own 26-yard line. Second down. Now he's scrambling. Tackle made around the 40-yard line. And out left to the running back. Tackle around the 44-yard line. Tackled after a decent pickup. Throwing. I don't think he got anything on that. He's scrambling. And he's going to come up with a sack. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 39. Let's it fly. Incomplete. Almost picked off. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Wake Forest is up four. Throws it in a hurry. He's taken down at the 23. Bring him down at the 33-yard line. They give to the tailback. Tackled for a loss. The defense was all over that draw play.
And they got very good containment on the halfback. He had nowhere to go with the football.
Throws it away. From their own 32-yard line, it's third down. And he's tackled at the 50-yard line. Gets to about the 47-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. Brought down at about the 45. Gets it. He's in space. And he's level at the 32-yard line. Wake Forest holds a four-point lead. Might have been some early movement up front. That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
So we'll have first and 15 after the penalty. Down after a nice run up the middle. So he calls his own number and gets about 6 yards.
the halfback on the screen. And he's taken down right around the 28-yard line. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. And he's tackled in the open field. Fourth down. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. He gets it up, and it's long enough. And he splits the uprights.
Yeah, he got some good leg behind it, and he kicked an accurate ball right between the goalposts.
10-3. Wake Forest. King fields it at the one. He's taken down at the 30-yard line. There's a flag down, and it looks like this one's coming back. That one's going to put him way back.
You just can't block a player from behind like that, or it's going to cost you.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Throws in the middle, and down he goes, around the 21-yard line. Makes it out to about the 29.
Watch the run, watch the run.
Scrambling around. He gets sacked on the play. From their own 27-yard line. Second down. Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. He's on the run. He's brought down in the open field. They come out in an empty backfield. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up. Wake Forest is up a score. He scrambles. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. Slides down to the ground. Hartman picks up about 7 yards there, scrambling away from the pressure. He fights forward to about the 49. He's hit immediately in the backfield. Got a man, but he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage. And they lose a couple there.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
It's 3rd and 13. Ball on their own 49. And he throws right away.
He's got it!
And they make the stop around the 17-yard line. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal. Get out, get out, get out.
Touchdown, Deacons. And he adds the extra point. A 7-play, 61-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
So our score, 17-3. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. And they got to him before he could get back to the line. It's third and 10. Ball on the 24-yard line. Go to the screen here, and the halfback's got it. He's tackled right around the 30. Brought down the 39-yard line. Wake Forest built on their halftime lead here in the third quarter, Kirk.
Well, I think they've done a really good job of finding some matchups to their advantage, and they've just gone after this defense, and it's allowed them to put up some points on the board.
That's three down and one to go. Wake Forest's lead is 2 touchdowns. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He makes it to the 42-yard line. And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. Gets it out in a hurry. Picked off. It's the cornerback.
I just don't think he saw the defender, and he threw the ball right at him. That's what happens when you focus on one guy. You get tunnel vision.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 42-yard line. Makes it to the 45-yard line. And he carries the ball for a nice game. He did not get to the first down marker. It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. Slings it out, and it gets tipped.
I'm not sure the offense had much of a choice here. It was a pretty short conversion. The defense just made a good play.
We'll have to see now how the offense responds this time after throwing a pick on their last drive.
Anytime you give the ball away, it's a disappointment. So these guys want to show that they can hang on to it.
Caught, and big hit there to stop him.
And off up the middle, and he's stuffed. So the offense will move a little bit closer with that penalty. From the 36-yard line, first down. And he hits him hard at the 35. So he gets maybe a yard on the option.
Quarterback is tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure, or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
Fires it out. Tackle made at the 30. Fourth down. So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. Kicks away, and it's good! Looks like they're ready for the kick. He'll take it from the 2. Tackle at the 28. Demon Deacons on this have really been all over the place. They're playing like a defense possessed.
I love to watch a defense just pin its ears back and just fly to the football. They are playing with a reckless attitude, and it's really paid off because it set up their offense to be able to score points.
Last time out, the offense wasn't able to convert on fourth down.
Hey, remember, you don't have to go for it on fourth down. The last time you had the football, you went for it on fourth down, and you didn't convert. Just think about this. If you move the ball into your opponent's territory and you want to take a chance and it makes sense to go for it on fourth down, I understand that and I get it. But when you're in your own territory and it's fourth down and 5 or longer, just considering a punt would make me so happy.
Runs with it, and he's got room. Tackle at the 45-yard line. Tries to buy some time, and he's going to be sacked. He's taken down at the 39. And they pick up the first down with a pass to the tight end.
It's easy to forget about the tight end sometimes coming off the line, but you always have to watch this guy because he's certainly capable of making big plays.
Now he's scrambling. And he has it on the corner. Dives forward.
Well, they didn't pick up the first down, but he saw that no one was open, so he made the right decision to tuck it and run.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Well, after that injury, we'll get to see the backup quarterback here. Got it, but he's going to lose yards here. Just under 3 to go in regulation. And he tackles him hard at the 28-yard line. He's scrambling, and they got him.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
It's the 9th play of the drive. And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
Well, that'll happen when you blitz the corner and the offense picks up the blitz. It's one less guy the quarterback has to worry about in coverage. Nice read by the quarterback to keep the drive going.
Fires back to the tailback, but he can't bring it in. It's the 11th play of the drive. Quick release. Oh, had it knocked down. They've looked good so far on third down in this drive. Let's see what happens here. He's under pressure. Throws a bullet. And he's got it. Going the other way now.
It looked like the pass was sailing out of reach, but he just climbed the ladder and made a spectacular interception.
Makes it to the 22-yard line.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want none. They don't want none of this.
From their own 22-yard line, it's second down. Just over a minute left.
Go!
They run left, and he'll lose yardage.
Sometimes a play is not going to work for whatever reason. Doesn't mean you throw the play away. You just need to execute better next time.
For a loss. Mora to punt. Team right now aware that they are a team. Hey, their star didn't shine today. Everybody else picked up the pace, though.
I think we all came in expecting to see that star player really shine. And the fact that they didn't have a great game from him and still won the football game, boy, I walk away from this game as a viewer just thinking even that much more about this team than maybe what I thought prior to the football game.
Well, that wraps things up for us. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.